Well, first, thank you for having us here and hosting many of us from McLaren at Davos, my first time, and it's certainly a very impressive event. Our partnership, we're very excited about, very happy to announce that this morning. You know, CNBC and McLaren are very like-minded, two big global brands providing great content to their consumers, a big B2B business doing business with global corporations, and we're all very focused on business and technology. And at the end of the day, McLaren is a technology business. We deploy that through our Formula One and motor racing efforts, our automotive business, and then of course our applied technologies business. So I think we share much in common around the globe. So very excited. I think we'll do a lot of good for each other.
I can hear the fans out there saying, ask him about the sport, the direction of F1. This is a sport that is seeking a new direction. You recently had a change of ownership completed last year. The new owners, Liberty Media, have been talking about a significant change for the sport. Are you witnessing that yet at the team level?
Yeah, we are seeing it. We're very excited. I think Liberty are the ideal buyer for the sport. It was obviously under management from Bernie Ecclestone for 40 plus years. Did an unbelievable job really building this global sport, but time to move on. And with that, you know, Liberty are global sports media experts. That's ultimately how everyone consumes our sport, is through different forms of media. And what they're doing is they're focusing on the fan, and that's the most important part of the ecosystem. So if we can have hundreds of millions of fans, which we do, around the world, communicate and engage with them in new and innovative ways, and we're seeing that now through different forms of fan engagement, embracing of social media and digital. So Formula One now is the fastest growing sport in the digital platform, be it from a small base, because it wasn't something that had historically been embraced. So I think there's nothing but good times ahead for Formula One and for McLaren.
Formula One is now under the stewardship of Chase Carey, a name that many people would know because he worked so closely with Rupert Murdoch for so many years. One of his early findings after compiling a whole host of reports around the sport is that there was just a lot of money circulating through Formula One, not necessarily in a good way, with a lot of money going to the most powerful teams, but not to some of the smaller teams, which meant they were struggling just to survive and to stay in Formula One. And also decisions around where the races have gone in recent years, whoever was willing to pay up with a big checkbook managed to secure races. How do you think these dynamics will change if money is still going to be a consideration?
Well, there's a lot of money that goes through the Formula One ecosystem, billions and billions of dollars. And so you would think as long as that's distributed appropriately, that everyone could make a healthy living out of that type of revenue that's coming in. We've been one of the big beneficiaries of being one of the big teams. But the view McLaren is taking is we want to do what's right for the sport, what makes it very healthy. And so there is an imbalance between what the top teams are getting and the bottom teams are getting. And we need a full grid to be competitive. And so I think that is something they're going to address. They're going to address cost cap because at a today, you know, here in Davos, everyone's talking about you know, how you refine your business, lean your business, be more efficient. And I think that's something that we have yet to do that Chase Carey and Liberty are going to do is help us get our escalating costs out of control, because I don't think you need to spend $300-400 million, which some of these teams do, and our budget's not far behind that, to put on a great, compelling Formula One race. So I think we're spending unnecessarily in some areas.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.